Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In this session, we will write a Java program to read from a text file and write into a text file. So the question says, read the content of a file named student.txt. The data in the file are comma separated. Each line will have a student ID, major, and GPA. We need to count the number of CS students with GPA below 2, and then we have to write the result in a file named result.txt. So what do we have? We have to do the following. We have a student.txt. This is my file. And we have many lines here. Each line will have the following. We'll have a student ID, comma, the major of the student, comma, and then the GPA. We have to go and count how many of these students are CS student and the GPA is below 2. According to the sample here, we have only 1. So we have to open another file, result.txt. And then we have to have a message saying number of students with low GPA equal 1 because we have only 1 student. So in this exercise, we need to open a file and read from a file, and the data are comma separated. And then we have to write the result and save it in another file named result.txt. So let's assume the following. I will have my student.txt, and I will assume I have only 2 lines, 2 students, and then another file result.txt where I have to write the result. The first statement is scanner input equal new scanner a new file student.txt. So this means I'm opening student.txt for reading and I'm calling it as input. So in this program, I will refer to this file as an input file. The other statement, it says print writer output, and then you have to go and just open the file for output. So print writer output, new print writer result.txt, which means you have to open this file and you will refer to it as output. The first file for reading, the second file for output. I need to count how many of students are CS and below 2, and that's why we need a counter. So we will need a counter, we will call it CS low, and the initial value is 0. Now we have to go for each line in our input file, so I will have to say input has next line. So go to your input, do you have a line here? Yes, we have a line. So go and do the processing. The first statement is get me this line. So we will declare a variable and we will say line. This is the variable. Input.nextLine, it means retrieve this line. So we will have the line 11, CS, 1.5. This is as a string. Because I have to know if this student is CS and I have to compare the GPA, it means I have to get the elements individually, the ID by itself, the major by itself, and the GPA by itself. And the way to do this, I have to do it in this way. First of all, I have to convert it into an array. So we need to create an array. We should have 3 elements. So the first one is ID, and then major, and then GPA. The way to do in this way, just simply say string bracket, give a name of your array, for example, ARR, line.split, comma. So take this line, and because we have comma separator, then automatically it will create an array, and the elements will be 11 will be in the first location, CS in the second location, and 1.5. in the third location, and it will take the index 0, 1, and 2. If you have here, for example, comma and whatever the email, also it will have it in the fourth field. So all what you need is you have to say line.split between double quotation comma. So it will just convert it from a string to an array. Then I need to do the following. I have to take the following. ID should be saved in a variable called ID. CS should be saved in a variable called major. And the last one should be saved in a variable called GBA. And the data type should be long, string, and double. because the array we created is still its string. These values are not double and long, they are actually string, but they are separated in index 0, 1, and 2. So now what we will do, we will just go and say, take this 11 and save it in the ID. So basically we can say ID equal the array at location 0. But because ID should be of type long, if we say long ID equal array at location 0, this is will not be done. And the reason is array at location 0 is a string and ID is of type long. And that's why we need to do parsing. So here you have to say long parse long array at location 0. So it will convert it from string, it will convert it to long, and it will save it in a variable ID. So here 11 will not be between double quotation, it will be just like a long ID. Similarly, take CS and save it in major. C is a string and major is string. So here we'll just say string major equal array at location 1. So this is again will be CS. The last one, GBA, I need to convert it from string to a double GBA without double quotation. So here I'll have to say double GBA equal double bars double array at location 2. So basically array at location 0 will be my ID, but I have to convert it to long. Array at location 2 will be of double, and we will save it in a variable named GBA. Then what I'll have to do, I'll have to say go and check major.equalCS and GBA less than 2. So go and check if this variable major is CS and the GBA is below 2. Yes, so I have to increment the counter and it will be as 1. So what we did now, we did it only for one line. So now at the end of the while, I'll have to go back and I have to repeat the same process with the other lines we have in our file. So we will go there and we will check, do you have line? Yes, still we have one more line. So the process is, the first thing is read the line. So we will read this line and we will save it in the variable line. So we will have 12 CE and we have the GBA as 2.4. So here we have 12 CE and the GBA is 2.4. Then convert it to an array. So once we convert it, just like comma separated, the data will be as follow. I will have 12, I will have CE, and I will have 2.4. And then I need to convert them to long ID, string major, and double GBA. So here 12 between double quotation, it will be only long 12. CE is still string, and 2.4 should be as a GBA. I have to check the condition. Is this a student CS and GBA? It's not, so I will not increment the counter, and we will go back to the beginning of the while loop. When you go back to the beginning of the while loop, it will ask, do you still have more lines? We don't have more lines, so we will exit the loop. Once we finish the while loop, this is the end of the while loop, we will come over there, and we will just say output.println. Because the main thing of this program is to write the result in the file result.txt, which we are referring to it as output. So if I say system.out.println, it will do the output on screen. Because I need to do the output on the file, I will say output.println, the number of CS students, and the counter. So the output will be number of CS students with low GBA. Now we are done with the writing. I have to go and do the closing of the file. So I have to say go to input and close, go to output and close. So it will go to the input file and close it, and go to the output file and close it over there. So the idea here we did is we have two files we need to open for reading and for writing. And that's why I'm using a scanner input for reading, I'm using printwriter output for writing. Student.txt is for input, the result is for the output. I need to have counter, that's why we created CS loop. We don't know the number of lines in the input file, so that's why I have a while input.hasNextLine. I have to read each line, and then I have to check if it is CS, if the GPA is below 2. And the way to do this is through the following. I have to read the line, the whole line, then I have to convert it into an array, and I have to mention that this is comma separated. If the question was saying that this is, for example, a hash separated, so basically all what you have to do is change between double quotation comma, you have to change it to hash. Then, because I know that the first one is ID, the second one is major, and the third one is GBA, so I have to declare variables ID, major, and GBA. If any conversion is required, like GBA here, I have to use the parse. And then I can do the continue of my program. Do we need calculation? Do we need if conditions or other? Once I'm done with the while loop, because I need to write to the files, I have to say output.println. And always I have to remember to close the files at the end. Now remember, these are files, so it's important that you have a try and catch. So that's why here we have a try. We have all the statements that we are doing within the files, and then we close the try. At the end of the try, I should have catch, and then I need IO exception. Here I'm using IO exception because I'm reading and I'm writing into files. So I'm expecting any type of error, file not found, file as read only, file does not exist. So I need exception that will work for both of them. That's why I'm using the general exception, IO exception. So for example, let's assume the following. Let's assume that the file that we are reading from, which is student.txt, actually does not exist on our hard disk and we are trying to read from. If the file does not exist, then you cannot do the reading, you cannot do the calculation, and hence you cannot do any output. So if we just from the beginning, there is no such file. If this file does not exist and you just mentioned I need to have scanner input, go to the file student.txt and open this file. If the file does not exist, it will jump there to the exception and it will output a message, file does not exist. So it will not open any file for writing and it will not do any counting. And that's why we need the input over there. And the other way around, if student.txt is okay, but the result.txt does not exist, so when you open the file input, it will be opened successfully. If you try to open the file result.txt and the file does not exist, just like what we mentioned before in the previous session, if you need to write to a file and the file does not exist, it will be created for you. So a new file will be created, an empty file, and then you can continue with your program and all the processing will be done.